Howdy folks, you're going to have to bear with me with the rain noise today. I've waited a while and the rain's not letting up, so I'm just going to have to deal with it. So it's about time to start charging the 33 Frigidaire. Got the condensing unit back in, new shaft seal for the compressor. I did have to check the motor out some more. You'll notice a new brush holder in there, a different brush holder. The one that was in there, I wasn't satisfied with how it was consistently it was cycling, so I changed that out and the motor runs a lot better. Lines are hooked up. This liquid line is actually on the low pressure side, so it'll have to have insulation on it, and that had deteriorated, so I got to go back and put that back once I get it running. Got all the cord grommets and clamps back in there. So I'm going to put the camera on a tripod and get ready to start charging it, see what happens. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is charge in just refrigerant vapor to try and eliminate the vacuum on the system, because I'm charging in on the low side and it's going into the compressor sump, so I don't want to put liquid in directly into the sump. So I'm going to just let in some vapor until it's no longer in a vacuum. And then once it equalizes with the refrigerant, I'll turn it on. It held vacuum with the pump isolated with its cutoff valve for about 2 hours. And then when I opened the cutoff valve, I didn't hear any change in the sound of the vacuum pump, which would indicate that moisture or air was going through. So that bodes well for it. And now, going to turn it on. Low side is still pumping down. Now of course on the low side it's got a can of refrigerant on the other end of the hose that's got to get itself ice cold before it'll pull down. High side's got about 60-70 psi. Now some of the sounds you hear is because of the 27 to 29 Frigidaires running on the other side of the room. And a lot of the noise is the rain, of course. So I'm going to let that run and go get a bowl of warm water to stick the can in to boil off the refrigerant. Okay, I'm back. I'm sticking the can in the warm water now to provide more vapor to the system. And being that it's a high side float, it's going to first have to condense that and collect it in the float chamber, and then it'll start circulating. Of course, that's in theory, assuming everything works. This line ought to get cold when it starts to circulate. First can's almost in. starting on the second can of refrigerant, and now the rain's picking up. Well, guys, I'm amazed we already have frost. I was not expecting that. I expected it would frost down there first, but maybe I just can't tell it. Yeah, that's cold. All right. Things are looking good. Close off that valve and let it stabilize and see, because being that this is a high side float system, it'll have to be charged to a certain frost line. You know, it's not as robust as the low side float, where you can pretty much, as long as that low side float, the receiver's full, it's going to work. This one, more similar to like a CK, it's going to have to be charged just the right amount. I'm going to let it stabilize, and I'm going to put a thermometer in the evaporator. I'm sorry to keep blocking the video with the door, but it's just because of where I set up the camera. So we're running about 6 PSI on the low side and about 125 on the high side, which looks real familiar from all the other stuff that I've done with this refrigerant. Amps on the motor, which is higher than it would have been with SO2, but it does a lot more work with this refrigerant. So I'm going to take a look. I'm going to take the camera off the tripod and take a look at the thermometer. Sub-zero, look at that. I just dribbled that water on there. It's already frozen solid. Well, my camera card filled up right as I was showing the thermometer sub-zero, and I continued to talk, and I was discussing that the control was about to cycle off, which it did, but it missed that part. So I'm gonna fire it back up and get to hear it start with load on the motor. Because right now we've got about 15 pounds on the low side and about 110 on the high, so it's going to be starting against pressure. How's that for a repulsion induction motor? That's actual real power usage. And again, this unit is massively oversized for this cabinet, so that may seem like a lot of power, but it's not going to have to hardly run at all like this. It'll run for just a couple minutes. Let's see that sweating now. I need to, that's the supply, liquid, low pressure liquid supply. And it's going to need to be covered so it doesn't sweat like that. All right, so that is first frost for this 1933 Frigidaire. Gonna give it some run time and make sure everything's stable and working properly. Control is operating a little bit cold, I think. I think it probably shouldn't be that cold. So maybe some adjustments will be needed. Well, I couldn't resist the temptation to put all the trim back on at the top and the cover. And also got the back cover on. So it's once again complete. I did put a round rubber cord back on this one. The connector is different because obviously it's three wire grounded now. Everything in there looks good. I think those little service ports actually look like they belong there. I mean, someone who really knows that they're modern, but the knurled brass actually kind of looks the part. Nice and cold in there. Come on, focus. And it's cycled off. Everything about this thing just feels like new. I mean, it's really in amazing condition. I did see signs on the motor and the compressor that it did have a good bit of running hours on it. So my guess is that the facility where it was if I remember right from some emails, it was a church or a convent. They had it in the basement, so probably it was just left in the basement running and not really paid attention to. And that's why the mechanical parts had some hours on them, such as the brush gear that I had to change. And there's actually some wear in the commutator. So it's done some work in its days, but I don't think the cabinet itself got handled all that much. So I'm going to do some research on what the evaporator temperature should be for the given positions here, because I think in the past somebody took that knob off and turned the shaft and got it out of sync, and I was careful not to do that, but probably had already been done. So yeah, this one is, I don't want to say the job is finished, but I'll say it's back together and ready for its proving test. And if it doesn't leak down or mess up after running for a couple of weeks, then it'll be good to go home. Thanks for watching.